Namaskar. Welcome to this module on Accident and Emergency Department. This is a very important department because emergency services are matters of life and death. These are the lifeline services of a hospital. So emergency services is an integral part of any hospital. It is also the front door of the hospital, the portal of entry that interacts with the highest volume of patients requiring critical care. Accident is an unexpected, unplanned occurrence which may involve injury or unpremeditated event resulting in recognizable damage. Emergency has been defined by WHO as a condition determined clinically or considered by the patient or his or her relatives as requiring urgent medical services, failing which it could result in loss of life or limb. Medical emergency is a situation when the patient requires urgent and high quality medical care to prevent loss of life or limb and for us to initiate action for the restoration of normal healthy life. The objectives of an emergency department include provision of immediate and correct life-saving treatment at all times and for all situations. Capacity and capability to provide effective management during disaster situations, liaison with courts and police in medico-legal cases. Provision of ambulance services, act as information and communication center, especially during disasters, to provide education and research. So if you see the slide, we are giving you a flow diagram of the patient flow in an accident emergency trauma center. Please study the slide. Planning and design parameters. The various considerations which should be followed are: the design and planning should be done so as to not hinder the movement of patients and staff and equipment. The equipment should be located in designated spaces to be readily accessible when needed. It should provide privacy during management of patients. There should be a minimum crisscross of patient traffic. Separate entrance and exit may be planned to facilitate unidirectional patient flow.
Apart from that, if you consider planning, we have a separate entrance for the OPD and ward area patients and a ground floor entrance for the emergency patients.
It should provide easy access for ambulances, patients and general public. There should be distinct, ideally separate access for ambulances and ambulant cases. The entrance should be easily identifiable, protected from inclement weather and accessible to the disabled patients. Depending on the type and location of hospital, a helipad may be planned.
So apart from that, we also have a helipad and we'll be soon starting with the air ambulance services. For any injuries in the remote parts of the country, we'll get the patients airlifted and they will arrive at a helipad which is connected through a lift, and we'll prepare an SOP where we'll calculate how much time it will take and it should take and who will accompany the patient to the emergency. We have a separate entrance for that. We'll go to the helipad also.
Ground level location is best since it avoids need for patient stairs or elevators and provides easy access for patients and ambulances. It should ideally be situated near the ICU and operating rooms. The patient waiting areas should visually be welcoming and comfortable. There should be a readily identifiable triage area with expansion facilities for utilization during management of disasters.
We also have planned a disaster area, which we use in case of mass casualties or at certain times like during the Holi celebrations, because we get a lot of patients with assault or roadside accident due to influence of alcohol. So we convert that area into the green area patient, and it works like a production line where the patient goes from one station to the other, and at the first station he's assessed, second station he's done the dressing and suturing, third he's given the medicines, fourth he's given the discharge slip. So all the green area patients, they do not enter the emergency at that time. The emergency only caters to yellow and red area patients.
It should have multiple walled in rooms or multi-bed bays. It should have an acute care rooms arranged around the main nursing work areas. It should have trauma rooms in proximity to the entrance.
This is the trauma center that which is a part of AIIMS itself. We take care of all the trauma cases, which include roadside accidents, any assault cases or any falls or injuries that happen to the patient. This is a 248 bedded center, which includes private rooms on two floors, 20 private rooms, and the rest 20 bedded polytrauma ICU and a 12 bedded neurosurgery ICU. So apart from that, all are general beds. We have an emergency which has 6 red area beds, 6 red trolleys, and observation beds for yellow patients and area for green patients. So we triage patients into red, yellow and green depending on the severity. The life saving and all the limb saving emergencies go to red area, and the patients who are a little stable but require observation and investigations go to yellow area, and all the patients who can walk and are ambulatory, who just require sutures or dressing, they go to the green area. And we follow a triaging protocol which we'll explain you downstairs in the emergency. Currently we have a good enough space, but we are expanding our emergency, which we'll show you. You must have seen that also. So we'll convert that into green area, and the red and yellow area patients which require a prolonged stay in the hospital, they will go to the old emergency itself.
The non-patient care areas should be located at the periphery in the floor plan. Doors should be wide enough to accommodate stretchers, trolleys and portable X-ray machines. A door of width 1.6 meters allows attendants to walk on either side of a stretcher or a trolley. Clinical care areas should have exposure to maximum visible daylight. For safety and security of staff, patients and visitors, it is essential to plan and design security features. An office of the security personnel near the entrance should be considered. Duress alarms should also be positioned at suitable places. Departments using telemedicine facilities should have a dedicated room with appropriate power and communication cables. Emergency department must have provision for emergency X-ray and ultrasound examination. It should also have provision for round-the-clock emergency imaging investigations. A laboratory room may be provided in the emergency department, or laboratory medicine department should provide round-the-clock services. Blood bank facilities should be available to the emergency round-the-clock. The floor finishes in patient care areas and corridors should have non-slip surfaces impermeable to water and body fluids and should be easy to clean. It will be ideal to provide separate fracture treatment and plaster rooms. The emergency operation room should be self-contained. The entrance should be well marked and illuminated. It should open into spacious lobby. There should be a porch outside the lobby to protect unloading of patients from rain and sunlight, and approach to the lobby should be in the form of a ramp and steps. Approach and access should be appropriate to usage by disabled, reception and information area. The following parameters are recommended. It should be adjacent to the triage area. It should be close to the waiting areas. It should have communication links such as telephones. It should also be utilized for storage of records. Waiting areas. The waiting areas should provide sufficient comfortable space for waiting patients and relatives' escorts. The area should be easily observed from the reception and triage areas. It should be appropriately furnished with visual displays on health education and hospital related information. It should have public telephone booths, coffee, tea vending machines, as well as toilet facilities separately for men and women. Nursing workstations. The following are recommended. It should be centrally located to enable staff to monitor patient care areas. It should preferably include central cardiac monitoring stations. It should have communication links to triage and resuscitation areas. It should have desks that will enable staff to work from either side. Doctor's work areas. It should be centrally located for facilitating response to an emergency. It should provide privacy. The location should be such that doctors and nurses are able to view central cardiac monitoring stations. Acute treatment areas. The acute treatment areas are utilized for the management of patients with acute illnesses. The areas should be able to fit a standard mobile bed with separate storage and usage space for essential equipment. The area should include a light wall mounted monitor, patient and emergency call facilities. There should be at least 2 to 4 meters of clear floor space between beds. Each treatment area requires a space of 15 meter squares. Resuscitation room. The patient is to be stabilized in the resuscitation room. Immediate attention is also given to patients who require restoration of blood volume of the body and clearance of air passages. The following are recommended. The resuscitation room bay should have space to accommodate specialized resuscitation bed, allow 360 degrees access to all parts of the patient for facilitating procedures, monitoring, and for resuscitation equipment. Imaging facilities should include overhead X-ray, lead lining of walls and partitions between beds, radiolucent resuscitation trolley with cassette trays, X-ray viewing, digital electronic imaging system. Ceiling mounted power column simplifies access of monitoring lines and devices. An OT light should be made available. All electric power should be on emergency standby circuits. Observation wards. This is utilized for patients who have been evaluated and need extended treatment, observation, re-evaluation, or time-consuming procedures. A 6 to 8 bedded ward is recommended. Special treatment rooms are planned depending on the type of hospital are as follows. Obstetric rooms. This should be equipped for pelvic examination, evaluation of the patients in labor, and emergency delivery. Decontamination room. This should have a flexible hose shower. Doctor's duty room. The doctors on duty must be available for all the 24 hours. For their convenience, a retiring room with amenities along with bath and toilet should be provided. Emergency department is an important component of healthcare delivery. It should be well planned and scientifically designed to effectively manage emergencies and disasters, as well as provide prompt and appropriate treatment to prevent death, disability and suffering. I hope the concepts of the emergency departments in healthcare and hospitals is clear to you. Thank you and Namaskar.